We are very, very happy to see what you sent today. Today, the teams have worked very hard to make sure at least we have met the minimum standards. There are one or two areas which we have mentioned which needs to be done to give that extra confidence that indeed Nairobi and in general our airports are ready for business going forward. We will provide the appropriate advisory, and then from there, His Excellency the President will make the announcement next week as to the way forward. The key thing is to be ready so that when it is announced, you don't start scrambling for interventions here and there. You must make sure you are ready in advance. And with that, then we can be ready to say on our part, we have done what is required. And that's why we are here. It's not just Jomo Kenyatta Airport. We are talking about Moi International. Kisumu, you saw already the inspection has been done. You know, Moi Eldoret. So we are doing all these things to make sure that the entire aviation sector, you know, is ready. And for us, Nairobi is a hub, and we cannot talk about opening the airspace without discussing Nairobi as a hub. And so our objective is to come and see activity, people flying in at night and flying in the morning. This is what will give us a lot of joy. But then we have done what we have to do to make sure that the protocols are ready. Yes. On the 6th or the 5th, people will be expecting some announcement. We don't know what it will be, because the Minister of Health must give that advisory based on a global view of all the issues, not just the airport, but also they must look at other parameters, like say the trend of the disease, of the virus. If say the trend is going the wrong way, even if you've done all this in terms of preparing for the facilities, he could announce that yes, we continue. Or if the Minister of Health considers that the trend is manageable, they could give a different advisory.